Do you know, the other night I was in a place called Asheville in North Carolina. And I was playing in a wedding chapel and I thought, this is going to be fun. And it turned out to be a tin shed on the outskirts of town with an Elvis Presley shrine. And I got halfway through the set, about here or somewhere in the throes of it, you know, and some guy at the back shouted, "Play Freebird!" And I'm like, why? Why would I do that? What fucking stupid thing. Like, I mean, and then I thought that made me sound like, well, you know, I'm a fan of Lynyrd Skynyrd, even though they are a deeply misunderstood band, and they were the first band, in fact, they were actually the first band to do an anti-gun song in the world, in the whole cosmos, I think. But then it got into a debate with some fucking fuckwit over there, with some other fuckwit over here, about which of the Lynyrd Skynyrd albums was the best. And I was amazed by people's ability to wander off the point. And I thought, it's no wonder this country and this world is in such a fucking mess, when everybody is so kind of diffused, and that they would then meet in the middle and have a scrap. While I sort of said, do you think you could take that outside? You know, over whether the first album or the third album is the best Lynyrd Skynyrd album. I don't know if anyone here has any opinions on that, but if you have, keep it to yourself. This song's very, you know, jaunty. It's like a folk song or something. It's like that. I think, feel like I could clog dance to do it if I had some boots and I had the ability to clog dance, but I don't have either. So we'll save that. But the subject matter is maybe a bit depressing, but it is quite jaunty. So its joylessness is counterbalanced by its, you know, because, like, I'd like to think I was bringing joy, but I'm probably not. There's a fucking fly up here. It's been landing on here. It's creepy, you know. It's probably my grandmother reincarnated. Or my mother. Eric, your tea's going cold. Yes, I'm 56 and a half years old. Actually, I'm 67 and a half years old, but that's by the... Sorry about this, I'm just, you know, working myself out.
Sleeping. more obvious. Now everybody's gonna
just a transitory thing. Here today, gone tomorrow. We'll be outlived by most of these things. Give me a smile.